Here's a tool you need to make sure you install every time you set up a new marketing site. It's Google Webmaster Tools. If you search Webmaster Tools or Search Console, you'll find it. It's going to ask you to log in with your account. And once you're logged in, you'll get a list of all the sites you've already added. I'm going to add a new property, and I'm going to add tinymarketingwins.com. All right, so now Google's going to ask you to verify that the domain is yours, and you can do this by uploading an HTML file, adding an HTML tag, using Google Analytics, or using your domain name provider. In this case, my domain provider is Hover, so I'm just going to select Hover from the list of domain providers, and I'm going to add this text record to Hover, and now I'm going to click the Verify button. I've successfully verified I own Tiny Marketing Wins. So when you first set this up, it's not going to be extremely helpful until Google starts crawling your site. One way to jumpstart that is to submit a sitemap. Now, if you're using WordPress for your marketing site, there are a bunch of sitemap generating plugins, and you can pretty much choose anything that has quite a few installs, a good rating, and is frequently updated. So I'm going to install this one here. And once I've activated it, I can see they've already generated the sitemaps here. So I can click on that and see the XML sitemap, and here is the HTML sitemap. So now I'm going to grab that, go back to the Search Console here, click on sitemaps. I'm going to add sitemap and just put in sitemap.xml. We'll submit that. And now it's processing that sitemap there. In next week's tip, I'm going to show you how you can improve your search rankings using the tools here in Search Console. But for now, I'd just like to give you a quick overview. So this is my dashboard for devmarketing.xyz. It's a site I've had set up here in the console for a while. You'll see in the dashboard, it gives you a status of your site, if there's any errors. It also gives you a brief overview of search analytics. And let's actually go there right now. So you can click on here, or you can click on the menu in the side, Search Analytics. And what this gives you is a representation of how your site is performing on Google search. And you can have it show clicks. Let's actually do it from the last 90 days, just so you can see a larger data range. So this is clicks to marketing for developers from Google over time. You can also add impressions in there. How many impressions does that query get? And click-through rate, what's the number of people searching for that term who are clicking through to your site, and what position your site is for that term. So let's use an example. So here's a query, marketing for developers. In the last 90 days, it's had 654 impressions. The click-through rate is 37%. That means 246 clicks, and it's position number one. And position is determined by a bunch of factors. It can include things like ads and other things, but if we search for marketing for developers right now, you can see that in this case, number one means the number one search result on that page. So this is a great way for you to see, how are people finding my website? What search terms are they using? Where am I ranking really well? And where do I need to improve? You can also see which pages are getting the most impressions in search results. So in my case, it is my root domain. The next one is startup marketing checklist. Lots of impressions, although not very many clicks to that page. They're obviously looking for something else, or I'm not giving them the result that they want. There's also a lot of potential traffic for this webcam review I have on the site, but again, not a lot of clicks. So perhaps that's something I could look to improve. You can also filter by country. So in my case, the United States is where I get most of my clicks from and most of my impressions. I get higher click-through rates from people in the United Kingdom and Canada, and then I can also look at devices. So in this case, I'm higher on mobile search results, both for mobile and tablet, and my click-through rate is higher on mobile devices. I will delve into search analytics in more detail next week, but let me show you a few more things. Another thing that might be interesting to you is to see who is linking to your site. So what websites are linking to you the most? And you can actually download a table of the latest links as a CSV or in Google Docs. And this is going to give you a list of the exact pages that are linking to your website. So for example, I'm interested in who's linking to me on Pinterest. Let's go grab that URL and take a look here. I can see, oh, look, this is a Pinterest board of startup books that have linked to my site. So that's interesting to be able to see which websites are linking to you. Sometimes you can reach out to those folks. Sometimes you can maybe leave a comment on the Pinterest boards that are linking to you. The other thing is, which is your most linked content? So naturally, your root domain is going to be the most popular, but in this case, Get More Visitors is the next most popular. And I can see, okay, who is linking to this website? And in this case, it's a site called thestartuppitch.com. But I can also see that it looks like folks were reading that on Nuzzle. And also, it was linked to from this Reddit thread. Another area you might want to look at from time to time is under crawl errors. And it'll let you know if there's any site errors and if there's any URL errors. In this case, it looks like I've got a couple landing pages that are no longer on the site that I need to fix. So one is this page here. It looks like I used to have slides on this page and I don't anymore. So that's something I should fix right away. And the other one that's interesting is this Fetch as Google. Now, again, I'm going to show you this in more detail next week, but I found this is a way to get Google to index your pages faster. So let me show you what I mean. I'm going to go create this missing landing page. I'm going to come back, and then I'll show you how I would submit it using Search Console. All right, I've just recreated this page, and now I want to manually submit it to Google. So I'm going to go back to Fetch as Google, paste in the landing page here, click Fetch and Render, and this is going to grind away for a second. And once it's done processing, this little button here pops up, Request Indexing. And I found when you go through this process, Google will index this site sometimes almost immediately. Look at that. I just searched for MicroConf slides marketing for developers, and there is the post I just created. It's already showing up in search results. So a really quick way to get Google to fetch any new pages that you create and have them show up in the index right away. All right, so that's a brief overview of setting up Search Console and some things you can do with it. Next week, I'm going to show you specifically how you can use it to get more search results for the content on your site.